I am going to tell how to sketch a region for a given double integral. It is a very easy trick to find a region for a given integral. That is, here they give that 0 to ln y e raised to x plus y with respect to dx. The first integration is this one. So here they give dx. So these are x limit. They are x is equal to 0 and x is equal to ln y. Similarly, after that they give dy. So these are dy limits. They are y is equal to 1 and y is equal to ln 8. We have to find first these four equations, and we plot a line on graph in xy plane. For these four equations, then we get the region what this double integral required. Now, what is x is equal to 0? Always y axis represents the equation x is equal to 0. Now, what is y is equal to 1? In y axis, where there is 1, here 1. We have to write a line parallel to x axis. Then this becomes the line y is equal to 1 at a point 1 on x axis. Now they give that y is equal to ln 8. What is the value of ln 8? We have to check in using scientific calculator. Ln of 8 is equal to 2.079. So this equation becomes y is equal to 2.079, where there is in 2 here, 2 in y axis. We have to write 2.079 approximately. There may be here it becomes y is equal to 2.079. So we can write a line parallel to x axis. Then this becomes the line y is equal to ln 8. The value of ln 8 is 2.079. Now they give another equation, x is equal to ln y. Now we have the equation x is equal to ln y. Then if we put any value in y, and then what get in x? If we put y as a 1, then ln 1 is always 0, so we get x is equal to 0. Similarly, if we put in the place of y, there is ln 8. That means then ln of ln 8, what we have to check in scientific calculator, ln of ln 8, that is equal to 0.73. Now why I had put ln 8 in the place of y? Because the line y is equal to ln 8 is here. So I imagine where the value where the x is in ln 8. To check it, I have put ln 8 in the place of y. So that becomes 0.73. Now we get 2 points here. Y is equal to, if y is equal to 1, then x is equal to 0. So 1 point is here. Similarly, if y is equal to ln 8, that means here y is equal to ln 8, then x is equal to 0.73. I think 0.73 maybe comes here. So I can mark here in the place of. Then if I can put another value to y, that is if between these two, that is 1.5. If what it becomes 1.5, we have to check in scientific calculator, ln 1.5, it is equal to 0.4. I think 0.4 may be come here in the x-axis. If y is equal to 1.5 here and y is equal to 1.5, then we get 0.4, it may be come here, so I can mark a point here. Here I can mark a point, then I get a curve. This is the curve which represents x is equal to ln y. Now the region, this region is, this is the line which is y is equal to ln 8, and this is y axis, so this is the line which is x is equal to 0. This is the line x is equal to 0, and this is the line y is equal to ln 8, and this is the line x is equal to ln y, and they give that the line x is equal to 0 and the line y is equal to 1. This is the line y is equal to 1 and the line x is equal to ln y and the line y is equal to ln 8. So the bounded region is this one. This is the region what we have required. This function e raised to x plus y represent the height of this height after this region. We cannot show in that in the graph, but we can draw a graph for this given limit. This is the required region. Now what is second problem? Second problem is 0 to pi, 0 to x into sin y into dy into dx. First we have to integrate this with respect to dy. So these are y limits. So equations are y is equal to 0 and y is equal to x, and these are x limits. So x is equal to 0 and x is equal to pi. Now what is y is equal to 0? Always x axis represents the y is equal to 0. Similarly, x is equal to 0, y axis represents x is equal to 0. And what is x is equal to pi? Now here pi means 3.14, we know that. So after 3, I think here it may be pi. So we can write a line which is parallel to y axis on pi in x axis, then it becomes the line x is equal to pi. So this is the line x is equal to pi. This is the line x is equal to pi. Now then another equation they give that y is equal to x. So if we can take equation y is equal to x, then what it becomes? If we put zero in the place of x, then we get y as 0. And if we put 1 in the place of x, then we get y is equal to 1. And if we put 2 in the place of x, then we get 2 in the y. And if we put x as a 3, then we get 3. So if we plot these points in this graph, then we get for x is equal to 1, y is also equal to 1. For x is equal to 2, y is also equal to 2. For x is equal to 3, y is also equal to 3. So we can write, we get a straight line. If a if we plot this in graph, this is the line which represents x is equal to y. Now this is the region what we required, so we can shade it. This is the required region. Now we have another problem. Third problem is (0, 1, 0, y², 3y³, e^xy into dx into dy. Now we have to plot a graph for this equation, for this given integral. Now they give that first dx. So these are x limit. So we can write as x is equal to y² and x is equal to 0. Similarly, then y. So these are y limits. They are y is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1. So these are four equations what we required. Now what is the line y is equal to 1? In the y axis here 1. So if we write a horizontal, a parallel line to x axis on this, then we get the line x is equal to y is equal to 1. This is the line y is equal to 1. Now what is the line x is equal to 0? Y axis is the line x is equal to 0. Now what is the line y is equal to 0? X axis is the line of y is equal to 0. Now we have to find a curve for x is equal to y². Now if x is equal to y², if we put in the place of y 0, if y is equal to 0, then what becomes x? Then x is also equal to 0. If y is equal to 1, then x is also equal to 1. If y is equal to -1, then x is equal to +1, because y² (-1)² = +1, 1. And if y is equal to 2, then x is equal to 4. If y is equal to -2, then -2² = +4, that is x. So we get the values we can put here. If y is equal to 0, x is also equal to 0, that point is here. And if y is equal to 1, then x is also equal to 1. Here y is equal to 1, then x is also equal to 1. So this is the point. And they give that if y is equal to -1, then x is also equal to 1. If this is y is equal to -1, and if this is y is equal to -1, then this is x is equal to 1. This is the point. And if y is equal to 2, then x is equal to 4. Here this is y is equal to 2 and this is x is equal to 4. So point is here. Now if y is equal to -2, then x is equal to 4. This is y is equal to -2 and this is x is equal to 4. So this is the point. We can get a curve from this. That is, this is the curve. Now this is what x is equal to y² and this is the line y is equal to 1. This is the line y is equal to 1. this is the line y is equal to 1 and this is the line x is equal to 0. Y, because y axis is the line x is equal to 0. Now this is the line y is equal to 0, which is x axis. So the bounded region is this one. This is the required region. Thus we can plot a region which is required by the given double integral. This is the easy method to find the region which is bounded by the given double integral. Thank you.